You're watching Minity Maths. In this video, we are going to cover the laws of exponents, also known as powers or indices. Practice questions and answers are provided at the end of the video. If you need an introduction to exponents, check out our video, linked above. Don't forget to like and subscribe. The laws of exponents are important because they provide a powerful framework for understanding and solving a wide range of mathematical problems, from basic arithmetic to complex scientific and engineering applications. So let's get started. The first rule sets out what raising a number to the power 1 means. Whenever we have a number to the power 1, it is equal to itself. Have a look at this example. Remember, if we were to multiply 7 by 7, we would write 7 to the power 2. But when we want to keep 7 as itself, we can use the power 1 to represent this. The next rule shows us what to do when a number is raised to the power 0. The answer will always be 1, no matter what the base number is. Have a look at these examples. The third rule sets out how to deal with negative powers. If we have a negative exponent, we should rewrite it as a fraction. Firstly, we write out the reciprocal of the base number, where the number 1 is the numerator, and the base number is the denominator. If you need a reminder of reciprocals, check out the video linked above. Finally, we then raise the denominator to the positive form of the original exponent. Have a look at these examples. The following two laws only work if the base numbers are the same. Rule number 4. When multiplying, add the powers. Let's have a look what this means. Here, the base number is the same, we have exponents of 5 and 2. So we keep the base number the same and just add the exponents together, giving us an exponent of 7. Let's see how this works and makes sense by looking at some examples. If we rewrite this example out without using exponents, we can see we do in fact have 7 multiplied by itself 7 times. Remember, this rule won't work if the base numbers are different. Law of exponents number 5. When dividing, subtract the powers. Again, this only works if the base numbers are the same. Here, we have exponents of 5 and 3. So for the answer, we keep the base number the same, and take away the exponent of 3 from the exponent of 5, leaving us with an exponent of 2. Let's have a look at an example. We can see that if we rewrite the expression out using a fraction and without exponents, we can cancel down the digits until we have 3 to the power 2. Law number 6. When raising one power to another, multiply the powers. Here we have a power 2, raised to a power 3. So according to this rule, we can multiply the exponents 2 and 3 together. This gives us an answer to the 6th power. Have a look at this example. We have 2 lots of 5 to the power 5, giving us an answer of 5 to the power 10. Law number 7. For fractions, apply the power to both the numerator and denominator. So here, we can rewrite this and apply the power, 4, to both a and b. In this example, we can apply the exponent of 3 to both the numerator of 2 and the denominator of 3. We can then rewrite the fraction without the exponent to understand this further, giving us a result of 8 over 27. The final law shows us what to do with fractional powers. Firstly, turn the base number into a root, using the denominator. Then use the numerator as the power to raise the base number to. So we are finding the fourth root of the base number, which has been squared. In this example, the denominator is a 2, meaning we find the square root. The numerator is a 3, so we cube the base number. Note that for this example, there is no need to write out the 2 in the square root, as it is convention to leave it out. Have a go at these practice questions and pause the video while you work them out. Thanks for watching Minity Maths. And a special thanks to everyone who has donated to the channel to keep it running.